Professor of EC Department at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. Welcome to the session of Satellite Communication. In the last session from unit number 8, we have seen how to calculate the system noise. We have seen a different satellite system parameters like EIRP, free space path loss, atmospheric absorption, atmospheric attenuation, likewise. In this session, we will cover the antenna noise, how to calculate the overall system noise, rain fading, and its example. Now, as we are going to start the antenna noise, we know that a transmitter antenna will also introduce a noise, as well as a receiving antenna will also introduce a noise into the system. Okay, so what are two different types? First one is the antenna itself introduces a noise, and second one is the sky noise. Okay, these two noise that we need to consider when we are going to calculate the link budget of downlink, uplink, or the combined uplink and downlink, right? Antenna noise is dependent on the angle of elevation. Now, what is the angle of elevation? Angle of elevation means it is a vertical angle. That means the angle between the satellite, or if I am going to consider this as my satellite, okay, and with reference to the center of the earth over here, okay. So vertical projection of the satellite onto the surface of earth, then this angle with reference to center of earth is known as the elevation angle. That is a vertical angle, while azimuth angle is horizontal angle, right? So this noise is dependent on the elevation angle. Little examples are, for earth station, if it is operating at the C band, it will be 60 k and the noise will be. For earth station, if it's operating on the KU band, then it will be 80 Kelvin. Antenna noise will be 80 Kelvin, right? And satellite antenna, the noise temperature is 290 Kelvin, it is fixed. Okay, so I can say that as the frequency is going to be increased, my antenna noise temperature is also going to be increased. Alright, it depends on the on which frequency band I am going to use. As frequency band is going to be increased, that is L, S, C, X, K, K, K. So my antenna noise temperature is going to be also increased, right? Now, as the effect of atmosphere is always there, okay? So in atmosphere, we know that there is a water content, there is a different gases like oxygen, nitrogen. So effect of that gas will also introduce a loss in my system, okay? So at which frequency it will introduce a loss? So this graph represents, this is the antenna temperature, noise temperature in Kelvin. This is the frequency. As you can see from this graph, as the frequency is going to be increased, my antenna noise temperature will get a two peak. One is over here, second one is over here. So this is at nearer to the 22.2 gigahertz. So this peak will introduce, because the antenna noise temperature is going to be increased because of the water content present in the atmosphere at the frequency of 22.2 gigahertz, resonant frequency, right? And as my frequency is going to be again increased, right? Approximately, I can say that 60 gigahertz, okay? So this peak will be there because of the oxygen which is present in the atmosphere, okay? So at 60 gigahertz, my antenna temperature will be at peak. And at 22.2 gigahertz, my internal noise temperature will be at peak. So I am getting a 2 peak because of the atmosphere's gas and the water vapor content. Alright. Now, as I have told you that the antenna noise temperature will depend on its elevation angle. Okay, I can say that. Sorry, as antenna elevation angle is going to be increased in degree, my noise temperature initially it was maximum, but as angle is going to be increased, my noise temperature is going to be decrease. Alright, so this is for the different frequency, like we have used 11.7 to 12.2 gigahertz frequency. Polarization is linear. So what is the effect of gain and what is the effect of noise temperature for different angle of elevation? I can say that for 10 degree elevation, what is my noise temperature? It is 47. For 20 degree, it is 36. For 30 degree, it is 32. Right? So as angle of elevation is going to be increased, this internal noise temperature is going to be decreased. Alright? Because it is dependent on the angle of elevation as well. What is ring fading? Now, as I have told you, because of the water vapor content at 22.2 gigahertz, I will get a 1 peak. Okay? Apart from that, because of the rain, attenuation is always present. So it is serious at the higher frequency, that is for C, Ku and Ka band. Likewise, so rain informations are available in the form of curves and tables where over here. This is the rain attenuation for cities and the communities. Over here, at different location for the raindrop of 1%, 0.5% and 0.1%, what is my rain attenuation? You can see this, all the quantities are in dB. Alright? Now, as we are going to consider a rain fading, what we need to do is we need to understand effective noise temperature of the rain. So the temperature because of the rain, that is T-rain, is equals to TA in bracket 1 minus 1 upon A. Now what is A? A is the rain attenuation, that is because of the parameter, temperature parameter that we need to consider, we need to understand what is the exact the rain attenuation is there. Okay. What is A? That is rain attenuation. What is TA? That is the apparent absorber temperature. Why? Because we are going to consider rain fading. Alright? Yeah. And the total sky noise temperature, that is T sky, that is equals to TCS plus T rain. Okay? Now we will see one example which indicates the effect of rain on my carrier to noise power density ratio. Right? First of all, the statement is given as under the clear sky condition, that is carrier to noise ratio power density is given in dB, that is 20 dB. Total effective noise is given as 400 Kelvin, and over here a rain attenuation is given, that is 1.9 dB and 0.1% of the time, because it is given as for specific period of time. Okay, then calculate the carrier to noise power which falls for 0.1% even a TA that is equals to 280 Kelvin. Now we are going to first calculate antenna temperature. Okay, for antenna temperature, what we need to do is TA is given. So TA in bracket 1 minus 1 upon 1.55. How it comes? It is the rain attenuation which is there, the 1.9 dB. So if you are going to convert absolute value, we will get 1.55. So the temperature is 99.2 Kelvin. Now, system temperature S is equals to 499.2. How it comes? 400 Kelvin, that is total effective noise. We need to add it to T antenna. Okay, so 400 plus 99.2, we will get 499.2 minus 400, we will get 99.2. If we are going to convert it that into the dB, we will find out that 106 dB. Okay, now over here under clear sky condition, this value is given, but after attenuation, what will be my carrier to noise power? So C by N is 20 minus 1.9 minus 0.96. How it comes? 1.9 is the regular wave attenuation. Okay, that is I need to subtract it, this quantity from the overall C by N, that is 20 dB, minus 0.96, which is system temperature. Okay, so I will find out that its value is 17.14 dB. Alright. Now the other parameters are already there. That is transmit power and emit energy, that is PT and PB. Now how we're going to read it? See, the energy per bit having the transmitted power at the saturation, and we need to consider the bit duration. Okay, so EB, that is energy per bit, is equals to what is my transmitted power and what is my bit duration. So EB is equals to PT into dB. So in terms of the bit rate, it is FB. FB is nothing but 1 upon dB, right? That is the inverse of bit duration, right? So EB is equals to PT upon FB. So what is EB? EB is the bit energy. It is going to be related with the transmitted power, right? Now, carrier to noise power density and carrier to noise ratio. What is the difference? If I'm going to represent carrier to noise power, that is C by N. If I'm going to represent carrier to noise power density, then C by N0. Why? Because for N0, it is equals to K into T, C upon KT, right? So carrier to noise power density ratio, if I'm going to represent in the dB, so C in square bracket minus N0, that is in decibel. Okay, both the quantities are in the decibel. Alright, now and second is bit energy to noise density ratio. What is it? EB upon N0. EB stands for bit energy, N0 means noise density. So if we are going to take the ratio of it, so it is a convenient method to compare a digital system using a different modulation schemes, right? So EB upon N0 is equals to C upon FB, that we have already seen, divided by what is N0? N0 is my noise power density. Alright, this is N upon B. Alright, so CB upon NFB. So the upper quantity represents the energy bit, that is bit of bit energy, and the lower in denominator, it is the noise density. Right, so EB upon N0, which is equals to carrier to noise, plus B upon FB. What is B? B is my bandwidth. Alright, so this is the way to calculate a bit energy to noise density ratio. Right, now if I am going to calculate G by D ratio, what is G by D ratio? It is gain to temperature. What is which temperature? Equivalent noise temperature, it is TE, right? So GTE is a figure of merit which is used to represent an earth station or the satellite, or I can say for the receiver, right? So how to calculate it? G by D is equals to gain of the antenna plus gain of low noise amplifier divided by TE. What is TE? It is effective temperature, right? So if I am going to represent the G upon T ratio in dB, then I have to use the square bracket. Now what is unit of G by T? Unit is dB per Kelvin. How? If I am going to represent the gain in decibel and temperature in Kelvin, So overall G by D ratio is dV per Kelvin. That is G antenna plus G LNA, which comes from over here, minus TE. Why? Because TE means the effective temperature, which is in the denominator. So if I'm going to represent in the decibel, then we need to place subtraction sign over here. Right? Let's take an example. For transponder G antenna is given as 12 dB. Gain of fluorescent amplifier is given as 10 dB. Effective temperature TE is given as 26. So calculate G by T ratio, that is figure of merit, for this all the quantities. Now, what is given? G antenna is given, G antenna is given, TE is given. We need to simply place all the quantities. 12 plus 10 minus 26. See, all the quantities are in decibels, so we can use directly. But if it is not given, then we need to convert that just all the quantities into decibel. Alright? Because the answer which is given asked into decibel. Right? So over here, satellite system parameters are finished. How to calculate the example based on that? What is the effect of atmosphere and ionosphere onto my signal? Okay, it is finished. So if you have any question, you can ask me on my email ID. Alright? Till then, thank you for your attention.